Hey folks, this is Vince with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and today we're going to play another game of X-Wing. So, I guess as you can probably tell, we're going to be using this beast. This is our first time playing with it, so we're going to get a few things wrong. Keep that in the back of your mind. Consequently, it is Vinny's turn to be the Rebel, so he's the first one out of both of us to get to use it. So, I think he's really excited about that. I'll be trying to blow it up with some TIE bombers and the fire spray. So, with that said, let's go ahead and take a brief look at what ships we picked and what upgrade cards go with them. Okay, here's a brief look at what I picked. I have the Fire Spray, it's just a standard Bounty Hunter, Flight Instructor, and the Cluster Missiles upgrade. Over here I've got three TIE Bombers, one Captain Jonas, two Scimitar Squadron Pilots. Captain Jonas has one Proton Torpedo, whereas both Scimitars have two Proton Torpedoes each. All of this comes to 115 points. Alright, and here's Vinny's fleet. He's just sporting the CR-90. He's got his forward and his aft cards here. For his forward section, he has the Mercenary Co-Pilot, he has the Backup Shield Generator, the Single Turbo Lasers, and the Tantive IV title. On the aft section, he has Quad Laser Cannons and the WED-15 Repair Droid. All of that comes to 115 points. Okay, a few things to note right off the bat. I do not have a dedicated video camera, so the coloring and the lighting may be off at times. Also, we play to have fun. While we try to get the rules right all the time, we're only human and we're going to make mistakes. And again, like I said, our primary goal here is just to have fun. So if we miss something, I'm not too worried about it. And this is our first time using this beast, so there's going to be some things that may be obvious to you that we're doing wrong that may not be so obvious to us. So, you know, nice comments are okay, but any nasty comments, keep those to yourself. So anyway, let's go ahead and move on to the planning phase. We'll do that off camera. And once we're done locking in our maneuvers, we'll get right back to you. Alright, we've locked in our moves, and the huge ship rules state that these things move last after the small ships and the large ships. So the pilot skill really won't matter at this point. So I'm just going to go ahead and move all of mine first, then he'll get to move and activate his. So I'll start with my twos here. Three slight turn. So I do that, and I do not believe I'm close enough for a target lock. No. So, let's go ahead and, I'll go ahead and perform a, what can I do? I could do a focus. Let's go ahead and do a focus. Next up, I've got another two over here. I'm going to go ahead and move him slight three as well. Slight turn. I will also take a focus action. For my three is a two slight turn. And his actions are focus, target lock, and evade. I will take a focus. And finally, my last TIE Bomber is also going three slight turn. Alright. And I will also take a target lock action. Now, yours is going to play out a little differently here. What were you going to say?
You mean focus?
Yeah, focus. What did I say?
Target lock.
Oh, yeah, I can't target lock. I mean focus. So yours is going to play out a little differently. So let's take this one step at a time. Let's go ahead and reveal your maneuver.
Two straight.
So you get, use this thing here. So let's move. All right, let's put the white line right there. And we move this up right above the blue line, right above the two's white line. So now you moved up two. How much energy do you get?
Three energy.
So here's three energy.
I will spend
the gaining of energy happens before the actions. So you get three energy. Now you get to allocate that energy among your cards or your ships or whatever the case may be.
I will put two energy here.
You're going to put two energy on your turbo, your single turbo laser.
And I'll put the other one
on your forward section.
How about this? Can you use the one attack with your second primary weapon? One energy. I'll put on the forward.
The forward section can't store energy.
Oh, but why can't it? So I spend one energy.
Put it on your rear, the rear part of, yeah.
Oh.
Put it on your rear card can hold five energy. Whereas your forward section has a primary attack value of four instead of energy. So I'm assuming your rear part of the ship can hold the energy while your front ship can fire.
But I'm assuming that your rear section can
spend energy to fuel your forward section or other upgrades on your ship because they're connected.
So, all right, so you've assigned 2 energy to the front single turbo laser and 1 energy to the rear part of the ship. Now you can use energy except for combat. Any non-combat related items like actions you can go ahead and use. You get, what do you got there? You have the turbo lasers, that's an action. I don't think you have any. Every energy spending thing you have is combat related. Your turbo lasers are action.
I probably could. What branches have to be the target lock?
Your target lock? That's a good question. Let me check the rule book. One moment. Okay, according to the rule book, the Tantive IV rule book, it says that the target lock action is performed just like in the standard rule book. So it's range 3 or lower. So you need to be at range 3 at least, which you're not. Now, if you're just going to do actions now, you get 2 actions. The forward section gets to take an action, and the rear section gets to take an action. The forward section, anything on the forward section's action bar or any upgrades it has, and then the rear section or the aft section can take any actions on its action bar or any upgrade cards that you may have in that section. So you get 2 actions.
What's the shield one?
The shield one, that is recover. You spend all of the shields or all of the energy on your ship card to gain that many shields back. You can allocate that shield, those shields to both the rear and the forward section. So you can put, if you spend 3 energy using that action, you can put 2 in the rear, 2 shields on the rear, and 1 shield on the front, whatever you want.
How about
the reinforce action will give you an extra evade result, and you assign that to either the front or the rear section. The front. Okay, now if I were to attack the front, you would automatically get an extra evade result when you roll for defense. Now, you do not have any agility, but if I'm at range 3, for example, you would still get to roll an extra defense dive.
Probably not.
If I use the primary weapon. There's a lot of what-ifs and if-thens, so we'll just stop theorizing. That is the reinforce action, the little arrows, or not reinforce, that is the coordinate action. You can give another friendly ship a free action. Since you don't have another friendly ship, that's kind of pointless.
Yeah. So, can you put 1 here? I'll just keep it there.
Yeah, you've already allocated energy to your rear ship anyway. Okay, now, energy can be stored. You can support up to 5 energy on that rear card. So you can save it for the next turn, if you want to.
Yeah, I do.
Okay. All right, so now you get 2 actions. You took the reinforce action, right? Is that what you wanted to do?
Yeah.
All right, so what did I do? I put it here. Let's put it here, just so we know, on the forward section. You get 1 more action.
I can't do any other actions.
Okay.
Unless I could do that again.
No, because that has to be on the other card, too. You used your rear section's action to give yourself a reinforce token on your forward section. But now your forward section can either target lock, which it's out of range, or you can coordinate, which you don't have any other ships. Any upgrade cards that you might have that use an action? I don't see any. So right now that's it as far as actions. We'll move on to combat, and I believe he's the only one that can fire at this point. We'll move on to that in a minute. Okay, combat phase. Let's see here. So again, that's the wrong one. None of my ships can shoot here. So, you get to shoot. Now, during the combat phase, you get to fire once with your primary weapon and once with each of your secondary weapons, assuming that you have the energy to use those secondary weapons.
I do have for the turbo.
So, let's start with your primary weapon first. What is the range of your primary
weapon? 3 to 5.
3 to 5. So, you have to be... This is the large ruler, by the way, that came with that expansion. I don't have this pinned, just so I can fold it and put it away. But anyway, so you are...
Range almost everything.
Well, closest, you are in range 4 of this TIE bomber, 5 of this TIE bomber, 5 of this TIE bomber, and I don't even know if you're in range of the fire spray. No. So you're in range 4 of this one.
Yeah.
Now, the standard primary weapon range penalties and buffs apply. I get not only one extra defense die for being at range 3, but I get an additional one for being at range 4. My normal defense value is 2 on the scimitar TIE bomber. So I would get 2 regular defense die plus 2 for being at range 4. Now, what's your attack value? 4?
4. But I'm going to use the primary, the forward. When if I'm attacking with your primary, you may spend 1 energy to roll 1 additional attack die.
Okay, so you're going to use, you're going to spend the energy on your rear section for your forward section to give yourself 1 additional attack die. So you get 5 attack dice with him. All right, this may hurt.
What else do I have? And his ability.
Well, let's worry about the next turbo laser later. Do you have any abilities that affect this die roll? The mercenary co-pilot, for example.
That's range 3.
Range 3, so that doesn't count.
Nothing.
Yet. Okay, all right, so.
And IV doesn't do anything.
All right, so you've got, you know what, I feel bad. Roll that, you have 3 blanks and 2 focus. Roll that again. I feel bad. Go ahead, roll again. That's just bad luck. Okay, you've got, now I don't feel bad. 2 criticals and 2 hits.
I get to change 1 to a hit. Jeez.
How do you get that?
Never mind.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's your turbo laser.
Yeah.
So you get 2 criticals and 2 hits there. So I'm going to go ahead and roll my 4 defense die. I've got 2 focus and an evade. I will spend my focus token to turn these over to evades. I get 1 critical hit. So I will take a face-up damage card on scimitar number 1. Damaged engine, treat all turn maneuvers, hard left or hard right, as red maneuvers. So I'm going to put that on my 1, number 1 TIE scimitar. Alright, now,
turbo lasers.
Secondary weapon. Question is, this is on your forward one, yes?
Yes.
Now, here is your firing arc. Your firing arc is not 360 anymore, it's these side ones. So now we're going to look at what you're in range of. According to this, you can attack, it goes right down the middle like this. So the only one that you can attack is this TIE bomber over here at range 5. What is the range of your
turn? 3 to 5.
3 to 5. Now there is no range penalty, I believe. This is a secondary weapon.
But because of the turbo laser.
Because it's a turbo laser, however, I get some defense. What is
you
it?
You get double.
Double my agility value, I think, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So go ahead and roll your 4 attack die.
That is.
And I get 4 defense die. 2 normally, but 2 extra. Double my agility. Alright, you got 2 hits and
I'll
a focus.
I'll use the turbo lasers in order to change 1 to a critical and 1 to a focus.
Okay, so you got 2 hits and a focus. You change the focus to a hit, as mentioned on the card, the turbo laser card. Alright, I have 3 evade and a focus.
I don't think you need
No, I don't need to use my focus. Okay, so I've countered that. Okay, and you have no more weapons to fire. Your aft turbo laser, your aft laser quad laser cannon does not have energy on it. And I think we're good. So that concludes this round, and we'll move on to the planning phase. Okay, we're going to move on to the activation phase, starting with my 2s. 3 straight. That is a white maneuver.
You can do a target lock action if you want.
Yeah, probably.
That's convenient. All
right, so I had T. And next up we have this 2, 3 straight ahead.
Might not be in range.
Maybe not.
Probably not.
We'll see though.
Barely.
Barely in range. Forward section again. Let's do H and H. Forward section.
I'm probably moving.
So. I know. Next up, let's move these out of the way. This one is 3 straight. Actually, the fire spray moves first. That is 2 straight.
2 straight ahead.
Okay. And for my action, I am not close enough for target lock. I will take a focus action. And finally, this one is 3 straight.
Oh, I almost hit their back.
Now, they move the same distance, so they weren't going to hit. This, they do touch. Well, yeah.
Barely.
Yeah.
So close.
So, I will W and W that. Okay, so you get to move yours now. You're going to do two straight ahead. Alright, so the way that we did, same as last time. You line up that white line with the blue line. Move the blue line up to the two. Alright, now you get three energy.
Oh my God.
Right?
Yeah.
And now you can allocate that three energy to wherever you want on your ship.
Two on here.
Two on the quad laser cannon.
Which will be probably in range. And
you've got one energy left to assign.
I'll keep it there for the for a special thing later I'll do.
Okay, so you're going to put one on the rear section of the ship. Now you get to take two actions.
Did this?
Oh, yeah, that's from last round.
Yeah.
I've got
I'll
to clean it up.
Thing.
You'll do the same on the forward section?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I'm attacking there because you have three turtles.
So now you get a second action using your forward section. Your reinforce was on the rear section. Action bar. So now your forward section.
Target lock.
Target lock. Okay. You can any of the three TIE bombers.
I'll do probably attack him. Do that TIE bomber.
This
yeah.
one here?
Yeah, the second one.
Okay. I think I mixed up. We got H and H. Yeah, we've got tokens mixed up here. W and W. T and J. That doesn't sound right. Let's do T and T. And I and I, here we go. I. And who do you want to attack? Which target lock?
The second one. Because I can't attack with the
primary. All right, so that is two actions. All of your energy is good. And now we'll move on to the combat phase. Okay, combat phase. Now, I was looking in the rulebook to see how the turn order worked here. During the activation phase, the huge ships move and activate after the small and large ships, but the combat phase seems to be a little different. It actually doesn't mention anything at all about them moving after these guys, so I'm going to assume that it's by pilot skill, in which case you have a 4, so I have two twos, a 3, and a 6. So the 6 shoots first, then you shoot, and then the rest shoot. So let's go ahead and resolve the 6 first. Again, I'm in range. Range 3. Yeah. Range 3 of the forward section. So as the W here, I will go ahead and spend my target lock to use my proton torpedoes. I've got one of those for Captain Jonas. And I get 4 attack dice.
I get
range 2 to 3. You have a reinforce, so that counts as one evade. So you automatically evade one of these. Alright, let's see here.
You can change one of your focus to a critical.
According to this, you may change one of your focus results to a critical, which I'm going to do. So I have two criticals and a hit. Now, I don't think there's anything I can do. Captain Jonas says that when another friendliest ship at range 1 attacks, so he can't reroll, but his friends can, so I have to stick with this. So I've got two criticals and a hit. You evade the hit with
the
reinforce.
Then I get two shields.
You have two shields. You had two shields. How many shields did you have on your forward section? 5?
5.
Okay, so you lose two. You're down to 3 shields on your forward section.
Oh, yeah, I got my backup. At the end of each round, you may spend 1 energy to cover 1 shield.
Okay, so the reinforce actually applies for the entire round. So it's not a one use kind of thing. So that'll stay there for the rest of these attacks. So the proton torpedoes gets removed. You are going to shoot. Let's see if your primary weapon can attack. You have to shoot at range 3 to 5. Now
I'm at range 3 for him and
these
the
two
fire
and
spray.
Yeah, at the fire spray and these two TIE bombers.
Attack one of the
him in here? Okay. So you get 4 attack dice, right?
I'll use his ability to spend 1 energy.
You're going
to
spend the energy in your rear section to... That just sounds wrong. The energy in your rear section to give yourself an extra... Yeah, basically you passed gas to get an extra attack die.
Okay.
Spend your sphincter muscles to... Yeah. just... Okay. 5 attack dice. We're having way too much fun with sphincter muscles.
Okay, let's go. Come on. Give me lucky.
Yeah.
I got a turbo lock to use, I think.
2 focus and a hit.
I'm attacking him, right?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, I have a target lock.
You want to spend your target lock.
I have to change one of the focus because... No, I don't. Oh, wait, turn.
That's your turbo laser. So you have 2 focus and 2 blank to reroll, basically. Are you going to spend your target lock?
Yeah, okay. I think I can do.
All right. Okay.
Wow.
That is 4 hits total. 4 hits, 1 blank. I get 2
range
defense
3.
Die. I'm at range 3, so I get an additional defense die. And this is going to hurt if I don't roll any evades. 3 blank, really? Ow. 4 hits. Okay, 4 face down damage cards. That is on scimitar number 2. Stupid scimitar.
No, it's a joke with my secondary weapon.
Yeah, now you have a secondary weapon. You have a quad laser cannon. What range is that? 1 to 2.
Probably not.
That is your rear section. So you have to do it from here.
Which is no more than range.
Right. Well, the rear section is... This is the closest from the range... Okay, yeah. From here... No, from the firing arc. Here. 1 to 2.
It almost hits that.
So the quad is not within range.
I need turbo lasers.
Well, the turbo lasers may have worked there, but...
I should have done.
All right, so your quad is not in range to fire. The firing arc was a little okay, but...
can't do it.
Right, and your turbo laser doesn't have any energy assigned to it.
I wish I could do that.
No. I already let you re-roll once in the beginning there, but... Okay. Yeah, see? All right, so now we're going to resolve combat on the remaining ships here. I am going to start with this 3. Am I in range, though?
No! Barely. I think barely.
If I can... 1...
Yeah, he's at range 3. Do you just concussion missile work?
I'm thinking. Cluster missiles, range 1 to 2.
Wow.
So I have to use my primary weapon. It's range 3. You get 1 defense die.
Plus
the auto evade there. Or the reinforce. I'm going to do my 3 now. I've got a focus. Okay, I can't. It's a hit and a crit. And a focus. So you take 2 damage. Oh, you can actually 1, because your reinforce counts as
and
an evade.
And plus, you're attacking the forward, right?
The forward section. So you lose 1 shield.
Again.
You're down to 2 shields.
Can you use this for that?
What?
The, regenerate for that?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yes.
On your next turn, when you use your actions, you can use your recover on your forward section, if you have
and
the energy.
Force.
Mm-hmm. Next up, we've got the 2 TIE bombers. So with this TIE bomber, I'm at range 2. For the forward section, I will spend my target lock.
I get 1 automatically.
I get
1.
4 attack die.
I automatically get...
Now, I have Captain Jonas's ability, so I get to reroll some of these. Let's see here. When another friendly ship at range 1, which I am, attacks with a secondary weapon, it may reroll up to 2 attack dice. So I'm going to reroll this. I'm going to roll this.
I already have this.
Yeah, I know you do. I'm going to reroll this 1 because I have 3 hits there. All right, I have a focus. So I wonder if you can reroll the same dice twice. No. Up to 2 attack. Okay, I'm forgetting. 3 hits, so you lose 3.
2
shields. You got hit twice because of the reinforce instead of 3. So now you're shieldless on your forward section. Finally, I'm going to use the last TIE bomber's torpedoes.
So I might be able to regenerate.
Well, we'll see. Range 3, target lock, spent. Proton torpedoes, let's use that. I get 4 attack dice. Again, Captain Jonas's ability, I get to reroll 2 of these. I've got 2 hits and a focus. I'm going to reroll the focus hit. So I've got 3 hits and a critical. Now, that cancels 1 hit, but there's 2 hits and a critical.
I'm not sure.
That's the forward. Here, that's the rear section. Here's the forward section. So here's your face up.
You must 1 energy to perform any action.
Let me see.
You must spend 1 action to perform.
You must spend 1 energy to perform any action.
No, I think it means for forward, I think.
Well, that's your forward. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't... I'm using the back.
I don't know how that works. It says You must spend one energy to perform any action.
I think it means
It says four. Any action.
I think it means forward.
You would like it to say forward, wouldn't you?
I think it means forward.
All right. Well, let me check the rule book or the FAQ and see. But it says any action. So, you know, if you're going to use the rear section to give your four, like, I don't know. Well, here's two damage cards for your.
I only have five left.
Okay. So there's that. I will go ahead and grant you the whole forward. That only applies to the forward section. I think it applies to both sections, in all honesty, but I'm going to be nice and not do that. So, okay, so that concludes combat. We'll clean up unused tokens. All right, and we'll move. What's so funny?
Crash right into you.
That's not. Okay, planning phase. Okay, movement phase or activation phase, starting with my two. I will do one straight ahead. And for my action, I will take a barrel roll action this way.
Good.
All right, next up we've got this two. Also going one straight ahead.
I don't think you can do a barrel roll.
I will target lock.
What section?
The forward section.
I knew that you were going to target that.
Next up, we've got the three here, also moving one.
Uh-oh.
Not very far.
But it might hit your own ship.
No, it's... The TIE bomber's too much to the right. And I will take a target lock.
But it might not be in range. It might not be at range 2.
I. And... The TIE Bomber. One straight.
How's that gonna do?
And I will take the... Let's see. X. Okay, W. I'll take the target lock action. Okay, now you get to... move yours. You're going one slight turn. So the way this works is, let's go ahead and you're going toward me. This is going to get nasty. Let's go ahead and put that in the groove like that. Okay? Now your ship moves.
Like that.
Here.
That's very close.
Alright, now you get how many energy
for
this? Three energy for that.
Which is awesome.
So, where's the energy tokens? There's two here. Where's the other? Oh, you've got two on your one card. Let's get another energy out of the box, I think.
The box isn't
there. You think about what you want while I get the other energy out.
I already know what I'm doing. I'm doing the reinforced action of the last round on the fourth section, because that's all it's targeted.
Alright, so here's some energy. There's an extra one. So you have three energy to spend.
I put the four stick in there. I'm doing the...
Well, before you do your actions, you need to assign your energy first.
No, that's not doing it.
Energy gets assigned before the actions do. So assign your three energy somewhere. Where'd you put them?
I'm not sure what range we're going to be at.
For what?
Target lock.
You're in range of all of them for target lock.
No, I mean, like, sure.
Well, don't worry about the... You can't use that in... What are you measuring? You don't know. I don't know either. Don't worry about measuring.
Target lock.
You're in range of a target lock.
Yeah,
everyone.
I want to make sure.
You are. What range are you, or what? Who are you targeting?
I might target someone.
Which one?
Wait, I can't use it because I'm about to spend.
You have to spend energy because of your critical damage there.
I put two here. I'll keep this.
So you put two on your front turbo laser battery.
I do.
And what about the other one? Where'd you put the other
one? I'll do this. The one right there.
And you
I'll
put...
use the... I want to use the cover. I'll use the cover action.
Okay, so let's backtrack here. We had three energy, right?
Yes.
On the front turbo laser, and you put one energy on the rear card. Now you're going to use the recover action to spend one energy to recover one shield on your forward section. Now, okay, and we agreed because that critical, I mean, I'm pretty sure it was meant for all of the ship, but that's fine. We'll leave it at that. You got one shield back from that. You get a second action now, or no, you don't. Did you do a target lock?
No.
Oh, you have to spend. You have to spend an energy to do.
No,
it.
I did the.
Right, but you get a second action, one for your forward section.
Yeah, I did the recover on that.
No, you can't do both. The recover and the reinforce are on the same card. The aft section. You can only either do one or the other. Do you want to reinforce your front section or rear section, or do you want to recover?
Recover one shield.
All right, so you're going to recover one shield.
No, I won't do the second action.
All right. So... Alright, so, yeah. You can tell this is our first time playing. Okay, so I think we're good as far as the actions go. We'll move on to combat next. Okay, combat phase, starting with my 6. I have no proton torpedoes. Luckily, I'm at range 1. Yes, I'm at range 1. So, I'm going to use my primary weapon. I have a target lock, so I can reroll that if I need to. Captain Jonas, pilot skill 6, 2 attack die normally, range 3 gives me, or range 1 gives me an extra 1. Alright, I get 3, and then I get to use my target lock if I want to. I have 3 focus, seriously? Alright, I will go ahead and spend my target lock.
Be fun, you get 3 focus again.
I hope not. Whoa, okay, 3, I got 1 hit and a focus. So, I lose 1 shield.
Now it's my turn.
I can't believe
turn.
I only got... Yeah, you get to fire
now
back.
Now it's my turn.
All right, now let's check your primary weapon first. You have to be at least at range 3 to use it. The only ship that you can attack with your primary weapon is the Fire Spray.
Yeah.
So you're going to attack the Fire Spray at range 3 with your primary weapon. You get 4 attack dice, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't have any energy to spend for that.
Okay,
so.
Now my...
Oops, I need to get 4 attack dice.
My agility is 2, so I get 2 defense.
Wait, it's range 3.
Oh, yeah, I get an extra one, yeah. Alright, 2 hits and a focus.
I will get any extra.
I will go ahead and roll this.
Wait, what range? 3?
3. Mm-hmm.
Change one of your... I can change one of my...
Mercenary co-pilot?
I could change one to a critical hit.
Okay, so you're changing that to... Okay, so you have 1 critical hit... I rolled my 3 defense, I got an evade, so the evade takes out the crit.
Now it's time for my 2 secondary.
Alright, now you've got 2 secondary weapons. Now, your turbo laser has to be fired at range 3 to 5, so again, you're going to attack him, the fire spray. Again, forward section,
but
here.
You double.
I get to double that, so I get 4 defense.
Well, range 3, I'll use the co-pilot ability.
Does that say primary weapon?
No, it says either.
Okay, good.
Alright. It doesn't say
so you're
it.
Good.
It doesn't say
so, the range 3 doesn't matter with a secondary weapon, with the turbo laser.
That's good.
So, I don't get an extra defense die because of range 3, but the turbo laser grants me a double my agility value. So
and
you go ahead
and... I get to change 1 focus to a hit.
Okay.
If wanted to.
So go ahead and do that. 2 hits and a focus.
I'll do that. Turn that into a regular hit, plus the range 3 mercenary pilot turns that into a critical.
So you've
hit.
Got a crit and 2
oh,
hits.
Wow.
And I've got 2 evades.
One
so
crit.
I take 1 hit, 1 critical hit, and I lose 1 shield, and I am down to 3 shields.
Now I'm using this.
Now you're going to use your quad laser cannon. You have to spend, actually, you spent your 2 energy on that to use the turbo.
I spend 1.
Spend 1 energy on your quad. You roll range 1 to 2. Who are you attacking?
Range 1 to 2, attack. Who has the most damage? I'll do him.
The 2 has the most damage.
Him.
Yep. Okay, so you're going to attack this guy here. Actually, hold on. Yeah, the arc is... Okay, you're good.
Range 2, I can... If my attack misses, I can spend another energy to attack again.
So you get 3 attack dice?
Yes. Plus... Whatever.
What does that say down here? This attack does not immediately hit, or does not hit. You may immediately spend 1 energy from this card to perform this attack again. Okay, so you get to.
It's
like a gunner card, the crew member card, or the Luke Skywalker crew card. Okay, go ahead and roll your 3 attack. Is it?
Yeah.
And I get 2 defense die. All right, 1
wow,
hit.
Wow, I'm probably not.
Well, we'll see. Actually, I better hope. I want to evade. Now you get to spend 1 energy
spend
if you want.
Again.
To roll that again, alright.
So, I get double my chance this time.
Yeah, I would have been glad with... Go ahead. Alright, what do you got? You got a focus, a blank, and a critical hit. Alright, I have to roll 2 defense. Give me an evade. One evade, I'm good. Alright, so no...
Wait, I got hit.
Oh, that was a focus.
Yeah.
Okay, so no damage there. Oh. Moving on to my ships, my... we'll start with my three. I am at range... two. Or, no. Yeah, the Ford's definitely range two. I will use my target lock to do my cluster missiles.
Oh yeah, you can do that twice.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm dead.
No, you're not.
My fourth section's dead.
Now, it says here, spend your target lock and discard this card to perform this attack twice. Range 1 to 2, 3 attack dice. So 3 attack once. Now, Captain Jonas lets me reroll a secondary weapon, a friendly ship at range 1. I'm at range... knocking Captain Jonas around. Yeah, range 1, I'm good.
You're so close to that range.
Not really. Alright, so, yeah, I get to do this twice.
So you can't do in the back.
So let's roll this. I got...
Wow.
I'm not going to re-roll this. I've got one hit and two crits.
But you have to, because of the cluster missiles.
I will, but two crits, or two hits and a crit. So you lose one shield. How many shields do you have?
Zero.
Well, how many shields did you have? Okay.
Zero.
Didn't you have one?
No, because I got killed because
Because Captain Jonas hit you. Okay, so you take a crit...
Forward action. No, that round one.
Oh, yeah.
Is it this one?
Yeah, So you get that one, and then two.
Discard one of your double pilots.
My, that's team members. No. It says the discard, let me see. Let me see it.
Right here. That's a double team member. I don't have a team member.
That's your, like, engineering team, fire crew team.
Yeah, I got a co-pilot.
Yeah, but that doesn't count. That's not him. There's other cards in the upgrade deck that are strictly like gunner team, and you don't have any of those. How many damage do you have? You have six damage. All right, now I get to fire again for my second attack. Again, I have Captain Jonas's ability on top of this. I will reroll. I've got a hit, a focus, and a blank. I'm going to reroll the focus and blank. Two hits and a crit. Take a crit.
Shit. Just place one of your cards that's equipped to... this section under this card. Can I use that upgrade into this card face?
So
I'm going to put this.
So basically, put it on one of
your... Yeah, I'm dead anyway.
Well, not so. Hold on. That's what we'll get there. Now, did you get the other two?
No.
Okay, so let's just put these here.
I'm dead.
No, you're not dead. Pay attention now. What this happens now is this flips over to the crippled side. Now, both cards need to be crippled in order for your ship to be destroyed. All the crippled side does is reduce what kind of abilities it has. And you have to discard certain things down on the upgrade bar down here. You've got two attack now, range 3 to 5, on your forward section. You still have two attack. Okay? And you have to discard everything but one crew member.
Right, even the turbo laser?
Yeah, the turbo laser too.
What?
So let's just put that off to the side.
That's just wrong.
That's just wrong. Okay, so...
now I can't use my turbo laser.
The turbo laser is not going to help you at close range anyway.
True.
So, alright. So
again, you have one left.
Now, you still have the rear shield, or the rear section alive.
Yeah, and
I didn't even hit that yet. Now I've got these two.
How about these? That got shield
generator. That's later.
Hold on. Your four section upgrade gains bar gains one additional crew member and two additional. Do I have any? Probably not.
One additional.
Yeah, it's Titan IV, and I put on the.
Well, you don't have you don't have an additional crew member. The Tanta 4, you don't have an additional. You didn't pick additional crew member. The only thing you lost was your turbo laser. The backup shield generator, was this on your forward section or rear section?
Forward, I think.
Well, then no. This goes away too. Okay. So. Let's focus now on combat here. Actually, I'm running out of time. Let me undo this and redo it. Okay, now we're going to attack with these two TIE bombers. I will start with the closer one.
I thought you were attacked with him.
No, I did not. I attacked with the six, remember?
And him.
And the fire spray. I used cluster missiles, but now I've got these two TIE bombers. I'm at range two with this TIE bomber. I don't have a target lock. I have to use my primary weapon. I get two attack dice at range two on the rear section.
I have a lot of shield.
I've got a focus and a blank.
That's not going to do anything.
No, it does not. Next up, I've got this two here. I'm going to spend my target lock to attack the... actually, no, my target lock was on the forward section. So I'm going to...
Wow. You can't do anything.
Alright, I think I can... I'm going to have to I can't remember how to remove these target locks. I think I can do that during the end phase. I'll have to look at the rule book. So I'm going to have to just use my primary weapon on the rear section. Closest base is range 2. One hit. So you lose one shield on your rear section.
Yeah. Which I can get back anyway.
Mm-hmm. All right. So that concludes combat, and we'll move on to the end phase. Again, I have to check the rule book as far as removing target locks.
Can you repair this?
Can you? No. Once a ship is crippled, that's it. So yeah, let me let me check the rule book real quick regarding the end phase and target lock. Okay, according to the rulebook, target lock tokens are only removed if the locking ship either acquires a target lock on a different ship or spends the target lock during the combat phase. So on my next turn, if I target lock your rear section, it'll simply move over there, I'm assuming. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to planning now. Okay, movement phase, starting with my two. I'm going to go 3 straight.
Which is going to be weird. And probably not going to be able to attack.
We'll see. Alright, I'll go ahead and take, depending on what you do, I mean, if you go straight, I'll be fine, you won't hit me. If you make a turn, your back end will move this way, so I won't be colliding. I will take,
But you might get attacked because you can't come back.
I'll take a target lock action. The T was on him, I think. WW on the rear section. This two is also going 3 straight ahead.
Which might still be attacked because they're probably not really attacked. Ooh, so close to hitting him.
Now I'm going to reassign my target lock to a different section, so the rear section there.
But you don't have. Oh, yeah, you do.
Next up, we have the fire spray, moving 2 slight turn.
What way?
Away from things.
But why would I attack that then? Oh, because you can attack me because of the side.
I have a rear arc too.
Yeah. I thought it was only for secondary.
Okay. No, that's Star Trek. That's Star Trek attack wing.
Oh, okay. Unless it's Voyager or Star Trek.
Yeah, something like that. All right. for my action, I will take, goodness. I think I'll take a target lock as well on the rear section.
But that's only good.
Finally, I've got a 3 hard turn.
What way?
Away from you.
Look, you're right behind him. Mm-hmm. You're fine during that. An obstacle.
No, I don't think so. And then for my action, I will take, I think I'll take a, can I do target lock? Yeah.
You could, but...
Yeah, I'll take a target lock.
It's going to be hard.
Jeez! Okay, let's go ahead and move yours now.
The giant Titan IV.
So your turn...
The tile still stays there because it doesn't do anything.
The Tanta 4, not IV. It's Roman numerals.
Yeah, they call it Titan IV.
It's 4, Tanta 4. Never mind. Roman numerals. V is 5, but the I before it makes it 4. Going 1 slight turn.
Yeah.
Here. And you get 3 energy.
You're not in range.
Probably not. You are.
Yeah, but not your...
So you get 3 energy to spend. I know I'm going to get lit up this turn, but I'm going to try and get myself in a better position. My goal this round was not to hit you.
The force action. No, wait. Why would I do the force action when...
It's up to you.
Recover.
So you're going to spend 1 energy. Did you assign your energy?
Huh?
Did you assign your energy?
Yeah, that's what I did. I put it to quad.
So 2 on the quad, 1 on the aft section.
Yeah, to save it.
Okay, so
to use that.
So you're going to now use 1 action, the recover action.
Yeah.
You get 1 energy, or you're going to spend 1 energy to get 1 shield.
Right. That fills me up again.
You have three full shields now. And you get... Actually, your forward section is now crippled, so you can't take a second action. All right, so I think this concludes the activation phase, and we'll move now on to combat. Okay, I had to move the camera because this thing was just blocking the view of all the TIE bombers, so I'll move it back after this is over. So, your primary weapon is actually you, primary weapon of two, attack die, range 3 to 5, right?
Yeah.
Your primary weapon can still attack the fire spray, if it wants to.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Okay, so you get 2 attack die, right?
Yeah.
All right, on my fire spray.
You get range 3.
Range 3.
I still have the mercenary.
Yes, you do.
I get to use his ability after.
All right, so go ahead and roll your dice before my battery runs out. 1 hit, 1 blank.
Turn that to
a... You're going to turn that to a critical with your mercenary co-pilot. I get 2 defense die plus 1 for being at range 3. 2
wow.
Focus, I take a hit. I lose 1 shield.
This is going to be a bad turn.
Uh-huh. Now your quad laser cannon. Who are you attacking?
Who has no damage?
What do you mean no damage?
Like no damage on
them. The bounty hunter has no damage. Well, range 1 to 2 though, right?
Yeah.
The fire spray is out of range.
Captain Jonas.
Captain Jonas has no damage on.
Yeah. Range 2.
Range 2. So you're going to use...
What are the other guys though?
Range doesn't... Well, they're... And it's a secondary weapon, so it won't matter. They're all within range of this quad laser cannon.
I'll do him.
Captain Jonas.
Wait, no. I want to do him.
The number 2 scimitar?
Yeah.
The one that has... 4 hits?
Yeah.
Or 3 hits on him already? 4 hits. Okay.
Wow.
So you're probably going to blow him up now. I get 2 defense.
And
star.
If the attack doesn't hit, I get to do it again.
Yes, you do.
Which I probably will.
2 wow. hits and a focus. Let me go ahead and...
Probably.
2 evade.
Wow.
So you get to re-roll those.
If I want.
Wait, how many attack die did you roll?
4.
You only rolled 3.
Oh, yeah.
That's alright, you didn't hit anyway, so I only roll 3 for this second turn. Go ahead, spend your other energy then to re-roll, since you didn't do any damage.
Did I have energy?
No, you used it for the recover action. Remember?
Oh yeah.
2 hits. Come on, give me 1 evade. 1 evade, 1 evade, 1 evade. Yes! Alright, I take 1 damage.
But it destroys your 1 shield.
No, I have 1 hull left.
It damages badly.
Yeah. Alright, so... My other ships can't attack, so we're just going to move on to the planning phase.